Students, in previous class, we have studied nomenclature of aldehydes. So, in nomenclature of aldehydes, one is remember the suffix for aldehydes R, suds, alkenol. And then, in common system, it is derived from the carboxylic acid, oic acid, or oic acid is replaced by aldehyde. Well, in ketones, in IUPAC system, we know, first you should know the suffix. Suffix for ketone is ONA, suds alkenol. And in common system, for naming the aliphatic ketones, first we have to name the two group attached to the carbonyl, that is C double bond O. The two group attached to the carbonyl, first you have to name according to alphabetical order. Then add the word ketone. For example, we have CH3COC2H5. Now that carbon CO is attached by two alkyl group. One is CH3, one more is C2H5. We know CH3 means methyl, C2H5 means ethyl. Alphabetically, ethyl first comes, then the methyl. So it's a ethyl, methyl, ketone. If both are identical, then you have to use the prefix di. So dimethyl, diethyl, like that. Depends on what type of group are attached to the carbon. Afterwards, In aromatic ketones, a benzene ring or C6H5 is attached to the carbonyl group, C double bond group. Then it is named as this phenol. For example, CH3CO, then C6H5. The name of this compound is acetophenol. CH3CO is aceto. Then phenol. So you have to remember, in the common system, if we have two alkyl group attached to CO, then name the alkyl group according to alphabetical order and then add keto, or you have to use the last one is keto. If the two group are identical, then you have to use the prefix di. Well, when we have a C6H5 or phenyl ring or benzene ring attached to CO, then we have a name phenol. Example, CH3CO C6H5. We have two group, one is CH3, another is benzene ring or C6H5. Set ending phenol. We know acetic acid CH3COOH. CH3CO, that means it is aceto. Next one is phenol. These things you have to remember in the nomenclature of ketone. So in common system, name the group attached to, in common system, for aliphatic ketone, name the groups attached to CO or carbon attached to C double bond O in alphabetical order. For aromatic ketone, hip, bench and ring, bench and ring is attached to carbon group. Then they are called phenone. When we are calling phenone, when we have a benzene, first you have named the group which is attached, then end with phenone. So in IUPAC system, so it's important. In IUPAC system, suffix is O-A-E, so it's an alkanol. So simple it is. What you have to remember in IUPAC system, what's the suffix? Suffix is alkanol, then you have to use the rule, that is numbering, branching, etc. It's simple, that you are studied in, you see, first year. Now let us write some examples for the different types of ketones. Making three columns, use it is, one is formula, then it's a common name and next one IUPAC name. So formula, first one is first member of ketone, CH3COCH3. So in common system, first you have to name the alkyl group and end with the word ketone. We have two identical alkyl, so it's some methyl, dimethyl ketone. Dimethyl ketone, it's similarly, or more common it is called acetone. Compared to dimethyl ketone, we are using the word acetone. Second one, CH3COCH2CH3. Now we have two group, one is methyl, another is CH2CH3 or C2H5. C2H5 ethyl, this one is methyl, so it's ethyl methyl ketone. Ethyl methyl ketone. Then we have CH3, CH2, CO, CH2, CH2, CH3. Well, here we have two group, this is called ethyl, and we know for three carbon it's a propyl. Since propyl, two possibilities are there, one is normal propyl and another is isopropyl, and we know for iso CH must attach into 2CH3 group. Here there is no 2CH3 group, here we have CH2 CH2 CH3, that means it is not iso. And we know CH2 attached to functional group is called normal. So it's a N propyl and ethyl. Alphabetically, this one comes first. So it's ethyl, then N propyl, normal propyl, ketone. But next one, CH3. Twice CH, COCH, CH3 twice. We can expand on C. So when it is expanded, CH is attached to CH, then CH3, C double bond O, CH, CH3, CH3. So CH attached to 2CH3. CH attached to 2CH3. So this one is isopropyl. CH2 2CH3. Isopropyl. Isopropyl. So 2 isopropyl group. Yeah, so it's a diisopropyl ketone. Because we have 2 isopropyl group, so it is called diisopropyl ketone. Diisopropyl ketone. Next compound is COCH3. We have aromatic ring or benzene ring, and we know it is called phenone. When we have benzene ring, phenone, and we have CH3CO. CH3CO means aceto. So it is acetophenone. Acetophenone. Then we are writing one more COCH2CH3. So number of carbon atom are 3. Propanoic acid. So it is propanoyl. Then phenol. Propanoyl. Next we are, so this one is called acyclic, sorry, anicyclic. So this is anicyclic, and we have a ring shape, so it's called cyclo. In cyclo total, the number of carbon atom in this ring are 5. So it's a cyclopentane, single bond cyclopentane. We have ketonic group, so it is cyclopentanone. Common name, we don't have a common name for this one, it's called cyclopentanone. I'm writing one more. This position is ortho, this position is meta, this one is para. Ortho, meta, para. That means meta methyl. Then cyclohexanone. Okay, meta methyl cyclohexanone. Well, IUPAC. In IUPAC name, as I told, suffix is O-N-A, so number of carbon atom are 3, so this one is propanoyl. Next one, number of carbon atoms are 4, so it is butanoyl. Numbering does not arise. Numbering arises when we have 3 or more carbon atoms in the one alkyl group. Okay, so here we have number because we have 3 carbon atom in one alkyl group. Number from here 1, 2, 3. Well, the name of this compound is methitprobutpenhex. So it is sorry, the number from this end. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So name of this compound is metiprobutpentex. So it is 3 or penten, sorry, hexen. 3-OE. Well, this one you have to expand it. To name this one, you have to expand it. CH, we have CH3. CH3. Here you have to write CH3 and CH3. CH3. Numbering 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Then it is 4, 5. So this is the long chain. On second and fourth carbon, we have methyl group. So it is 2, 4. Dimethyl. Number of carbon in the long chain are 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is pentanone or penten. Write 3-ONE, or simply you can write pentanone. So name of this one is, we know CO is the first carbon, C double bond O. So it has a functional group. When we have a functional group, that carbon itself is number 1. So on the first carbon we have C6H5, and we know it is called phenyl. The name of this one is 1-phenyl. This is carbon number 1. 1-phenyl, then 2 carbon remaining, ethanol. 1-phenyl, 1-phenyl, ethanol. What I have to say is, on this carbon, on the carbon number 1, we have phenyl or benzene ring. Total number of carbon here are 2, so it's ethane. E is replaced by ONE, so it's a, on the first carbon phenyl, so it's a phenyl ethanol. What about this one? It's a carbon number 1, 2, 3. Now, the name of this one is 1-phenyl, then methylpropanol. 1-phenylpropanol. 1-phenylpropanol. Then, here, so it's a cycloalkane, cyclopentane, is replaced by ONE. So it is cyclopentanone. Next one, we are on the third carbon atom. So carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. So it is 3-methyl cyclohexanone. 3-methyl cyclohexanone. What I remember? By naming the ketones by common system, you have to see whether it is aliphatic or aromatic. If it is aromatic or possessive benzene ring, then it ends with phenone. So acetophenone, benzophenone, etc. in common system. And in aliphatic, if two alkyl groups are attached to CO, then name the two alkyl group according to alphabetical order. Then use the word, it is a ketone. So it is alkyl, alkyl, ketone. Alphabetically you have to name the alkyl group. Well, after this, let us discuss about the preparation of aldehydes. I think you are followed how to name the ketones by common system and IUPAC system. Now discuss on the preparation of aldehydes, and afterwards it's the preparation of ketones. So it's a preparation of aldehydes. Preparation of aldehydes. Preparation of aldehydes. As we know, we can prepare aldehydes from primary alcohols. We have two methods to prepare. tetraaldehydes from primary alcohols. One is dehydrogenation, that is by the removal of hydrogen from primary alcohol. And you are using copper or silver catalyst, the temperature is 300 degrees Celsius. Already you are studied in alcohols. And second, aldehydes can also be prepared by oxidation of primary alcohol, and a good reagent to convert primary alcohol into aldehyde is PCC, pyridinium chlorochromate. That also was studied. So I don't want to discuss with that again. We have few more methods used to prepare aldehydes. So one is from nitrile or from cyanide. So this was given by a scientist, not one prisoner, one more scientist is there. So that can be reduced, cyanide or nitrile can be reduced to imine by treating with stannous chloride and HCl. So your imine hydrochloride is formed. Afterwards, imine hydrochloride is converted into aldehyde by hydrolysis. So it was given by Stepan, so it is called Stepan reduction. So let us discuss the first method. Number one, first one is from cyanide or nitrile. From cyanide, or it is also called nitrile, by Stepan's reduction. Stepan's reduction. What is Stepan's reduction? Or what reagent you are using in Stepan's reduction? The reagent used is stannous chloride and concentrated HCl. What's the first product? Imine or imine hydrochloride. That on hydrolysis gives aldehyde. So cyanide is reduced to aldehyde by treating with stannous chloride. Stannous chloride and hydrochloric acid. So reaction I am writing cyanide or nitrile, it is also called nitrile. This is called nitrile or cyanide. So it undergo reduction by SnCl2 and HCl. SnCl2 and HCl. So product is imine or CH, then it is double bond NH, HCl. It's called imine hydrochloride. Imine hydrochloride. Imine hydrochloride. So imine hydrochloride on hydrolysis gives aldehyde. RCHO, RCHO, one more is NH4CO. So example is CH3CN. We know CH3CN is called methyl cyanide. According to IUPAC, methyl nitrile, methyl cyanide. Cyanide. According to IUPAC, it is called ethane nitrile. So ethane nitrile is reduced to aldehyde. So one is SnCl2 bar HCl. Second, hydrolysis. H2O. H3O plus. The product is CH3CH4. It's called, you know, acetaldehyde or ethanol. Acetaldehyde or ethanol. Next, you can try the second example. Second example is CH3CH2, Cl. So it undergo hydrolysis, I mean reduction in hydrolysis by SnCl2 and HCl. The agent is SnCl and HCl, and second one, hydrolysis in acid medium. The product is CH3, CH2, CHO. This is the product. Set is propanol. Total number of carbon atoms are 3. Set is propanol. You can also prepare aldehydes from cyanide by using diisobutyl aluminium hydride. It's called DIBALH. Diisobutyl aluminium hydride. So nitrile is treated with diisobutyl aluminium hydride, followed by hydrolysis, gives aldehydes. So reducing agent is diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Cyanide can also be reduced, to aldehyde by using diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Aluminium hydride. So cyanide can also be reduced by using DIBALH. It is called DIBALH. DIBALH. So cyanide are C triple bond N undergo reduction by DIBALH diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Diisobutyl. So that is iso diisobutyl CH3 twice CH. So it is diisobutyl. Means isobutyl, it is 2 times aluminium hydride, AlH. Diisobutyl aluminium hydride. So this one, treating this one, followed by hydrolysis. Number 1, number 2. We get this product R. CH2 aldehyde. Example CH3, then C triple bond N. We know name of this compound is methyl cyanide or ethane nitride. So using DIBALH, and second one is with H2O. Product is CH3. So here ethane nitrile or methyl cyanide can be converted into aldehyde by using DIBALH. So product is ethanol. Well, in this case the DIBALH selective reagent, because it do not reduces the double bond. Example, so it is CH3, CH double bond CH, is CH2, and across is CH2, C double bond N. The name of this compound is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is X, then it's 4 TNA nitro. So this double bond do not convert it or reduce it into single bond by Dibar. So it's a selective region. Dibar H. The product is CH3, then CH, so double bond CH, CH2, CH2. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. CH4. Well, that number belongs carbon only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, the name of this compound is X. Now, the 4 carbon we have in, then it is 1R. Or you may say X 4 in R, because when we have an aldehyde group, it must be terminal carbon, so it is Merite H4EN1R or simple H4ENR, because on the first carbon surface we are ready. Well, afterwards, second method is this from toluene by guitar selection. Retard reaction. Toluene is oxidized to aldehyde by heating with chromyl chloride in carbon disulfide or in carbon tetrachloride. Toluene is oxidized to Toluene is oxidized to benzaldehyde using oxidizing agent chromyl chloride in CCl4 or CS2. So toluene is treated with chromyl chloride Cr2 Cl2 in carbon disulfide. Well, the reaction takes place in two steps. At first, complex is formed. We have CH, then OCrO, OCrO, HCl2. We have one more OCrO, HCl2. So this gives aldehyde. So it's easy to remember, two hydrogens are replaced by OCrO. Now the hydrogen is here, Cl2, and one more it is same group here. So this is the progression now. Benzaldehyde from toluene and selection is called guitar selection. So we have a woman to complete this one at home. Write IUPAC name of toluene. IUPAC name of toluene. One is CH2 double bond CHCHO. This is called chlorine. Common name is chlorine. protein. And one more is, we have CH3 twice, CH double bond, CH3 twice C double bond, then it is CH3. It's called acetyl oxide. These two are common name, common name of the sun and common name of the sun. It's a common name. Common name for this compound, IIPC. Common name put in it, chlorine, but acetyl oxide. You have a new IPAC name on the break. So, it is about preparation of aldehydes and our discussion nomenclature of ketones. So, nomenclature, remember our common system, alkyl ketone, according to alphabetical order, that means alkyl, and in IPAC system, you have to remember IPAC system suffixes ONA, and afterwards numbering is important. And when we have this phenyl or benzene ring attached to CO, then it's called phenol. For example, CH3CO, C6H5 is called acetophenol. And if we have like this compound, the common name of this compound is benzophenol. As I told, the C double bond O attached to the benzene ring means it is a benzo. So we have benzophenol. This is a benzo, then we have phenol. Benzoyl acid, benzo. C double bond O is attached to benzene ring, so it is a phenol. Common name of that compound is benzophenol. Preparation of aldehydes, this method is important. That method is called Stefan's reduction. And second one is from its Itard reaction. In Itard reaction, you are preparing aromatic aldehyde. In Stefan reduction, you can prepare aromatic or aliphatic aldehyde. Only cyanide converts into aldehyde, and reducing agent is stannous chloride and concentrated HCl. Cyanide can also be converted into aldehyde by using diisobutyl aluminium nitrate. So it's called dibalage. And dibalage, that reagent is selective. Okay, so when we have a double bond, the double bond is not converted into single bond by dibalage. Must be perfect in all these. At the same time, must be careful for coronavirus. Coronavirus may be very careful agar bhaiko, especially if the old age people are there at home, to take extra care for old age people like your grandpapa, grandma, or your parents. Because they have less immunity compared to the youngsters. You must always use the mask and sanitize your hands or wherever your body comes into contact with the other things. Maybe some other cloth, different person cloth, or maybe some other different person comes in contact with. Or any materials the person having that comes in contact with your body, there is a possibility of corona. It's not 100%, rare it is. And always you have to use the mask when you go outside out of the house. Take extra care to your parents. Ma, atwa, manalajja, jitre, or the guest with extra care to your body. Immunity kadumi irutte. Corona attack ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ರಿಕವರಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ಯಂಗ್ಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಇಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ಉಂಟಂತೇಳಿ ಫ್ರೀ ಆಗಿ ತಿರುಗಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಇಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಕೇಸಸ್ ಯಂಗ್ಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು, ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಕೂತು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿರಿ, ವಾಚ್ ದ ರೀಲ್ಸ್ ನೋಟ್ಸ್, ವಾಚ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್, ರೈಟ್ ಎ ನೋಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಬಿ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೆಲ್ಫುಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಿ ಇ ಟಿ, ನೀಟ್ ಆರ್ ಜೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್. ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಇದುವರೆಗೂ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಉಂಟು ಎಷ್ಟು ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಅದು ಇದುವರೆಗೂ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ನ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೋರ್ಸನ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಲೀಟೆಡ್. ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ಆಗಿ ಅವರು ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅದು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಸಿ ಇ ಟಿ ಆರ್ ನೀಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೆ ಇ ಅವಾಗಲ್ಲಿ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಹಿಡಿತಾರೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ, ಹೇಳಿ ಕೂಡ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸಮ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ತಯಾರಿ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಗಾಡ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ ಯು ಆಲ್.